Hello and welcome to the CS++ video series. This is the series where I am attempting to make computer science topics as approachable and as accessible as possible to anyone who might be interested in these topics. I'm going to discuss basic logic gates in this episode. Now, this episode is in the CS 101 series. I do recommend that you watch all the videos in the 101 series before moving on to the 201 series. But basic logic gates. These digital logic circuits, are how all computers work. Everything in a computer is built up of these logic gates. Now, you've been exposed to some of these concepts if you watched the episode on truth tables. This is an inverter. This takes some input, and the output is the opposite. Now, there's several different ways that we can write this. Let's go for the sake of the bar. So the bar means that the output is inverted. So I'm going to erase these and we're going to say this is A and this is A bar. So if I put in true, then I get false out. If I put in false, then I get true. Now I'm going with this bar notation because this is what a lot of electronics documentation tends to use. This is AND. We've got two inputs and the output is A and B. So if A and B are both true, then the output is going to be true. And anything else is false. So this can also be written as something that kind of looks like A times B in Boolean algebra. And then the OR kind of looks something like this, where we're seeing the limits of my ability to draw these symbols freehand. So this is if A is true or B is true, then the output is true. So we could kind of, using our shorthand that we had before, if both A and B are false, then the output's false. Otherwise, the output is true. Now, this can be written in Boolean algebra as something that kind of looks like A plus B. All right, we're going to cover now one more gate, and then I'm going to kind of combine some of these topics a little bit. And this one has a symbol that looks kind of funny. Well, I can write it like this, first of all. A XOR B. That's not very helpful. Or A with this plus with a circle around it, B. Again, probably not very helpful, but the idea is that the output's only true if A or B is true. So let's go ahead and write out kind of a little shorthand truth table here. The output is only true if A or B exclusive are true. So in the case where they're both false, then the output is false. In the case where they're both true, then the output is false. But in the case where exactly one of them is true, then the output is true. Okay, so now this is where things get a little bit interesting. I put this little dot here on the inverter output. This is a not. That is the actual inverter itself, if you will. So we have things like NAND, which stands for not and. And basically, we're just taking the output and we're applying this little inversion to it. So this is something that could be written as A dot B with that bar over the entire thing. So we take whatever and would be and we invert it. So and is only true if both of the inputs are true. That means that NAND is only false if both of the inputs are true. Which means everything else is now true. Just invert the logic of what we have here for our little shorthand for and. And you can do things like nor. And again, this little dot here says invert the output, which means this is going to be the opposite of or. Now, or is true if either of the inputs are true. Well, let's go ahead and write it out. Okay, so we're just going to do the or operation first. And so the output here would be false. The output here would be true, true, true. And then when we do the inverse of the or, we're going to get true, false, 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 which means it's only true if both are false. Compared to NAND, that is only false if both are true. Now, we're not going to get into this today, but both NAND and NOR have a special property. So you can make all of the gates with only NAND, and you can make all of the gates with only NOR. So most or a lot of digital logic is actually constructed from NAND gates specifically. They're cheap to construct and you can combine them in many ways. I'm going to wrap this episode up by pointing out that that little dot can be in all kinds of places. So if you wanted to, you can make up your own gate that looks like this. It's a NAND with one leg inverted. So if we take our list of possible inputs, false and true, and then we consider that this is A, this is B. Now I'm gonna kinda rewrite this. Well, I'm gonna add the not A. So now I'm kinda looking at these group right here, and I'm doing the AND of those. And then we're doing the final operation, which is the inverse of the last thing. And if we go back and read the original chart, we can see that this thing is only false if A is false, and it's true in every other situation. All right, so that is today's lesson, basic logic gates. My homework, I think, combine XOR and NAND into some interesting combination. So you might have like, say something like this. So I've got two inputs going into the exclusive OR. One of them branches off, goes into the NAND. The output of the exclusive OR goes into the other leg of the NAND. And then that's inverted because it's a NAND. And, you know, play with this. Combine some gates together. See what kind of random logic things that you can create. And see if you accidentally created another logic gate that already exists in some other way. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next episode.